Here's our panel. Katerina Vandenhoevel is the editor of The Nation. She's in New York. Terry Holt is in Washington, who is national spokesperson for the Bush-Cheney reelection campaign. In Washington is Christopher Hitchens of the Vanity Fair scene and a supporter of Barack Obama. And in Washington as well is Babe Buchanan, CNN political contributor, president of American Cause. The McCain campaign launched a new TV ad gang using the words of Obama's running mate, Joe Biden. Take a look.
Listen to Joe Biden talking about what electing Barack Obama will mean.
Mark my words. It will not be 6 months before the world tests Barack Obama. The world is looking. We're going to have an international crisis to test the mettle of this guy.
Fair or not, Katrina?
You know, we're already in an international crisis. I mean, I consider this financial crisis a security international crisis, and we are seeing these two candidates tested in real time. Well, he talked about how, you know,
one coming,
but I would argue that Mr. Biden, who is not known for, you know, discipline with his words, you could argue that we are already in a financial crisis, and the country has turned toward Barack Obama because they respect the way he is handling the current crises.
All right.
So I think the judgment and the judgment question. He has shown.
Answer the question.
Terry Holt?
Yes.
What do you make of that ad?
Well, I think it's a fundamental question that people have to decide on before they go into the voting booths. To me, it seems every election comes down to a basic question for voters as they, but just before they pull that lever. And framing that question is essentially what the campaigns are about. There have been fits and starts in this campaign. I think most of us have been disappointed that it hasn't been more focused on the consequential issues of the day. And in this case, I think that it does. It says, is this guy ready? He's a great guy. He's a beautiful public speaker. But is he the kind of person we want to put in charge of this country when our country's survival may be at stake?
Christopher is bringing up the Biden quote. Isn't that fair? He said it.
Absolutely. And actually, as someone who's not a huge admirer of Senator Biden's, I think it's one of the best and most honest and tough-minded things he's ever said. Of course it's true that something like that will happen. Just to give you an example, everybody now knows, who cares to know, that the Iranians have spun their centrifuges much, much closer to the point where they can weaponize their nuclear program than anyone had previously thought. That's a challenge in itself, whether it's thrown down as a gauntlet or not. Actually, Senator Obama's already said how seriously he takes that as a threat. I mean, it would be idle to say anything except what Biden did say. It's obviously true.
Okay.
Self-evidently.
Okay.
Well, it's a very legitimate ad. And Larry, I think the key point of this is what was Biden suggesting is that this man who's absolutely inexperienced, Barack Obama, who has never shown any kind of leadership skills whatsoever in his public career, that is now going to be president of the United States. Therefore, there's no question in Biden's mind that these terrorists and these enemies of ours are going to test him. And that's something the American people should consider before they vote.
Oh, wait, that only makes sense if you think no one would try and test John McCain.
Oh, no, they will be far less likely to test John McCain because they know John McCain is most likely going to respond within 12 hours and they don't want to be bothered.
But, Bay, the hyper-militarized, atavistic Cold War policies of a John McCain are so badly suited to the 21st century challenges we face that I believe that he would cause more turmoil in this world with his response than promote security. Barack Obama has spoken to a different kind of foreign policy. I disagree with Christopher Hitchens on his, Barack Obama's talk about ramping up a U.S. occupation of Afghanistan. I think that will destabilize Pakistan and might be the end of the hopes and dreams of an Obama administration if we want to rebuild this country.
You know, but Katrina,
I got to get a break. Hold on, I got to get a break. Sure. We'll be right back.